You're about to learn how to make watchable shorts faster than every software you know. I'm talking by a factor of three. Trimming video with thumbs on a phone is absolute madness. But with a decent laptop and TimeBolt, you get the satisfaction to bathe in the tears of editors chasing AI unicorns as they are stuck in an endless loop of reading, stopping, clicking, and fixing. All the times AI cuts you off mid-sentence, and TimeBolt doesn't guess for a 20 times more accurate start and end to a cut. In this course, I take video from my iPhone, I cut out the boring parts faster than I record, and export a fully cut timeline into CapCut for final design, again, faster than it took me to record it live. I will show you how to record, run automations, cut anything with a keystroke, enhance what you keep, export to CapCut for captions and effects, and finally fix anything fast with File Doctor. TimeBolt is a Swiss Army knife of workflows. Every workflow you see here is a one-to-one edit to record speed. If you need to create a lot of content or simply want the capacity to, you're at the right party. Let's jump in. There are plenty of videos out there on YouTube on how to record good video and audio on your phone. In the past, I've used a lavalier mic. I got one for 20 bucks. Now I use the Rode wireless mic. Both give me entirely workable audio. With these Rode wireless mics, I'm typically recording at half level to get the audio and decibel level right once it's imported into TimeBolt. Let's get into the software. Think of TimeBolt as a video editor that turns on and off simply by when you talk. What is kept is in green, what's red is cut, silence is skipped in preview like it never even happened. First thing I do is get the video from my phone and drop it right into TimeBolt. Silence is auto-detected in seconds. Now the project that I'm showing you how to edit was a 60-second demo commercial for TimeBolt. I had to submit it as part of a one-minute pitch competition, so that is the goal, a one-minute vertical video. First thing that we're gonna wanna do is get the silence detection settings right. You'll test anywhere between a decibel level of -30 to -42 dB. But if you did forget to use a mic, you might see a low volume audio warning right here. Now to fix a low volume warning, just go to settings, click audio normalization, noise reduction, and volume increase, then restart the app. Now once you do this, the old file will be reloaded back into TimeBolt. And your audio will sound jacked, but it's just for preview purposes only. It will not impact the final output. It is just so TimeBolt can better read your audio waveforms. Now, I'm not gonna get into an entire tutorial on what these settings do. If you have questions, click this question mark. A video pops up and tells you what the settings do. But what you're going to wanna do is make sure that no audio is getting cut off in your clip by scrolling down the timeline. If you do see audio getting cut off, you're going to change this filter below sound level, nothing else. You're going to test between -30 to -42 dB to capture more or less audio. Now, if you do see audio getting caught like this, what this is it's ignore detection shorter than 0.75 seconds. This is actually catching coughs and mic strikes. This is actually me coughing during the video. Leave that at 0.75, it's perfect for unscripted video. And you can always see what exactly you're cutting by clicking flip timeline, and it'll show you just the content you're cutting out. I flip my timeline back. If you change any settings, make sure you click update silence detection settings. And if you end up getting totally screwed up and messing with these settings, you can reset to default values by clicking here. Now, if you've gone off script, the last automation you're gonna run is with check. Check will check for ums and ahs, hit start audio transcription. With check, you get 3 free trials. You can purchase a bank of credits, and there are 50 cents for every 10 minutes of video processed. Once check runs, you can add any unique word tick or phrase. Simply type it in here. Click run false start detection, which catches random stutterances when you restart a sentence. Now with this particular video, it wasn't unscripted, but you're typically seeing a timeline full of 10 to 15%, nothing but filler content. Hit turn off selected words, and now all my ums and ahs and repeats are removed for me. You've learned how to record, run automations, and now after check, 85% of the work is done for you. And now let's fine tune cuts with keys USOB. No, I'm not calling you that. Now sure, you can come in here and turn scenes on or off by clicking the bar above the playhead, or going over here and clicking create splits to create a split in the playhead. But why do that? That's to be going entirely too slow. What I want you to do is first put this at 1.5x preview speed. That way when you hit the space bar,
bad for people, it's good for video, COVID.
You're already previewing default at 1.5x. Just hit the space bar. Do not hit the play button. So let's go through the keys. U. So after you've been editing, as you're going through the edit, I hit U.
Have you ever noticed what
and it jumps back three spaces. It keeps you from having to stop the playhead with spacebar and then go back and then re-listen to what you just watched. Just click U. S creates a split. As you can see right here, it created a split. If you need to cut the beginning of a word out or the middle of a word out in the middle of a sentence, S create a split, and I can cut that out, anything out from inside the middle of the timeline. TimeBolt is a full timeline editor. That's S. O turns existing scenes off. O. That is a very fast way to turn off scenes. You can hold the O key down and it'll turn off huge swaths of content that way. The last key is B, the B key. Now, this is a great key. Imagine you're previewing your scene in your timeline.
No one watch it. Today,
and I don't like what I just heard. Instead of stopping the playhead, I'm having to stop it. That way it doesn't sound all crazy, my other voice going on behind it. But I just hit the B key and it back cuts what I just watched. So as I go through this, I don't even have to stop the playhead. I can literally just hit O and B and move extremely fast. There is no other faster way to cut or keep scenes or words out of a long timeline.
But for a bad video can hurt, and you're very
don't like that, boom. And of course, if I don't like something that I just did, let's say I turned this off, I hit Command Z to undo that existing cut. Go here for a list of keyboard shortcuts. This will change how you edit video forever. It will change your relationship with how you edit video. It's so fast to turn scenes on or off once everything's in your timeline is already all cut up with precision. Now, as I cut on the first pass, I enhance what I keep with punch. The expectation is I watch it once and I can edit everything on the first pass. I use punch between cuts to draw the eye in. I hit the letter P. As you can see, punches in 108%, go up to 150, 175, okay? And as I move through the timeline, I can actually do it on the fly. I can hit P three times to cycle through the punch area, okay? I can also do Alt or Option and the arrow key to actually change the focus area of the punch. And so what happens is in between cuts, it punches in and out. Now with a talking head video, I need really more precise punch coordinates as I'm punching in on my face, like 150 does not work. What I would do, go to settings. I'd change my punch values. Let's say 112, and let's go to like 118, done. And now when I cycle through the punch area, as you can see, doom, 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 112, 118, the three different punch values, they work out perfectly for a talking head video. Of course, I can also go right click and select the zoom amount and also change the focus area, but why do that? Again, that's just to go way too slow. Hit the P key, you're gonna love it, it auto resets, and then the Alt or Option and your arrow keys to move where you want the punch values to be seen. So by the time I get to the end of my timeline, I'm done editing. Sure, I'll run back through it to do a final preview, but it's at this time I'm going to go down, and if it's unscripted video, especially, I'm gonna hit activate turbo mode. Even though this is scripted, what I want you to recognize is that the duration is 1 minute and 4 seconds, 64 seconds, and I needed this to be 1 minute in duration. And instead of having to go out and cut an additional 4 seconds out of my video, I'm also gonna use turbo mode. So what I'm gonna do is, in turbo mode, I'm gonna limit this time to 60 seconds. And what this shows is it's gonna speed up my video by 7% to hit the 60 second time limit. And what's great is that I'm not gonna sound like a chipmunk, it's just my rate of speech and words per minute increases. And now, how I export is the secret sauce. I'm going to hit export clips to a folder. I name the new folder Shorts. Select folder, start rendering. And now each cut is rendered as a single clip with speed and punch values all baked in. We are at the home stretch, folks. Now I'm gonna click import. I select all of my clips, there are 17. I import them into CapCut, drag them down, and they all import in sequential order with speed and punch values once again baked in. You now get to start in design software in CapCut with a fully cut timeline. You can also do this in other editors that don't accept XML, just export clips to a folder. Now it's super easy to come in, add your effects, add your transitions. I can then do captions. And believe it or not, what's interesting is that auto captions become much more accurate when all of your timeline is cut up and the 35% of a timeline that doesn't need to be there is gone. Now there are plenty of great YouTube videos on how to use CapCut. One of them, which I'll link right here, is Vindy Steinberger. She uses TimeBolt. She explains how to make vertical video for LinkedIn extremely well. I'll put a link to her video right here and also gets into the specifics about how to edit with CapCut. But before doing your design, you're gonna wanna make and check to make sure that your audio and video stay in sync throughout the video. If it doesn't, okay, the likely culprit is that you've recorded as a variable frame rate file. And to fix this, I want you to click File Doctor, which is shown right here. Okay, File Doctor will check for variable frame rates. If anything is found, it will auto convert to constant frame rate. Your exact same project cuts are applied automatic to your file and you simply hit render again. Problem solved. Now, my goal with these courses is to improve your productivity and effectiveness with video communications across the board. As I create more learning courses for these pillar workflows, I'm gonna place the links to them all right here, and I'm out of time.